गुड आफ्टरनून एवरी वन, वेलकम बैक टू महदी इंग्लिश स्कूल. माई सेल्फ खुशबू दारानी एंड आई एम टेकिंग योर इंग्लिश एंड ग्रामर. टूडे वी विल रिवाइज पोयम टू, बर्ड ऑन द शोर. टूडे वी विल रिवाइज पोयम टू, बर्ड ऑन द शोर. एज माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम ऑलवेज टेलिंग यू दैट revision is must. Why? Because revision can connect you to the present lecture. A previous lecture always connect you to the present lecture. So my dear students, today I will teach you how to recite this poem. So let's start with our poem. What is the name of the poem? The name of the poem is The Bird on the Shore. What is the name of the poem? The name of the poem is The Bird on the Shore. So, my dear students, when I explained you this poem, first we have done warm-up exercise. So, today also we will revise it. Okay, let's start. Tick the things that we should do to keep a park clean. When we are visiting any park, any public places, then what things you have to do? Number one, litter on the benches in the park. Litter means garbage. So, what do you think, my dear students? Is it a good thing to throw a garbage, to throw a litter, to throw a waste on the benches in the park? Of course not. It's not a good thing. So we will put wrong here. Number two, leave used plastic bottles under trees. So is it a good thing to leave used plastic bottles under the trees? Of course not. It's not a good thing. So we will put wrong here. Number three is collect food and waste in paper bags and throw them in dustbin. Collect food and waste in paper bags and throw them in dustbins. Yes, you should throw the waste in dustbin. Number four, pluck flowers and leaves from the garden or from the park. Are you allowed to pluck the flowers or leaves from the trees? Of course not. So we will put wrong here. Number five, allow pets to dirty the park. Allow pets to dirty the park. Is it a good thing? Suppose you are having a pet like cat or a dog. So is it a good thing to allow your pets to dirty the park? Of course not. So we will put wrong here. Then number six, take your litter home if you can't find a dustbin. Litter means a garbage. If you can't find a dustbin nearby you, so you should take your trash, you should take your garbage at home. Yes, that's a very good thing. So, my dear students, remember all the points whenever you are visiting a park. Right? So, let's start to recite our poem. When the sea becomes dirty, many birds and animals that live in and around it are affected. Read this poem about a girl that is rescued by a kind father and his son. Rescued means protected, to save. This poem is about a bird who becomes dirty because of sea pollution. So, let's start. A sticky skein of oil is floating on the sea. A sticky skein of oil is floating on the sea. And any bird caught in it needs our help to break free. And any bird caught in it needs our help to break free. In the first stanza, the poet is telling about a sticky skein of oil. Oil is sticky.
Right. It is floating on the sea. Oil is always floats on the water. So any bird caught in it needs our help to break free. Stanza 2. Just like the girl we found, half dead among the sands. Just like the girl we found, half dead among the sands. We wrapped him in a towel, but still he packed dad's hands. We wrapped him in a towel, but still he packed dad's hands. Here, poet is talking about a bird named Gull. Gull is a seabird with a loud call. Loud call. Call means a voice here. A loud voice. A gull is a bird which we can mostly find near the sea coast, near the sea area. So, which was not alive, not also dead. And we wrapped him in a towel, but still he packed dad's hands. Packed means the gull struck the father's hands with its beak. Do you observe, students? Then if you are trying to catch any bird, then what they will do in their protection, they will start to point out with the beak, right? So here girl was doing that. Now let's move to the next stanza. It's not a job for us, dad said. He needs some expert care. It's not a job for us, dad said. He needs some expert care. I think I know a place. They will make him better there. Now in this stanza, father is telling to his son that we have saved this bird. We have caught this bird, but it's not our job. We cannot save him properly. So, dad is telling to his son that we should take him to the expert care. Who can care? Who is a doctor of animals or a birds, right? So, what it is called of doctor of animals or birds, that you have to tell me in your homework, okay? Let's move to the next stanza. They scrubbed and cleaned our girl, then showed us several more. They scrubbed and cleaned our girl, then showed us several more, which had been black with oil and half dead on the shore. Which had been black with oil and half dead on the shore. So in this stanza, poet is talking about a father and a son who visited a place where more birds were there, who were black with oil and half dead on the shore. They were also same like a girl. So how experts clean them, that is also mentioned in this stanza. Expert scrubbed and cleaned the girl, and they also showed several more girls, several few more girls to the father and the son. Now let's move to the last stanza. Last stanza and the first stanza both are the same. A sticky skin of oil is floating on the sea. A sticky skin of oil is floating on the sea. And any bird caught in it needs one's help to be free. And any bird caught in it needs one's help to be free. Here, again the poet is giving us a warning that a sticky skin of oil is floating on the sea means still the sea is polluted. All the water bodies, rivers, ponds, lakes, sea, all the water bodies are polluted. So, if any bird caught in it needs one's help to be free. We can protect ourselves by the pollution, by everything. But birds and animals, especially marine insects, they can't protect their lives. So, we should help them. Let me show you this picture perfectly. See, here how a father, a son rescued the girl. Rescued means to save. See, the black skin of a girl. They wrapped him in a towel. Right? So, my dear students, always keep this thing in your mind that never polluted anything, especially water, because water is an essential thing of animal lives, of human lives. Every living being needs water. So, please take care of these things. Okay? So, my dear students, now I would like to show you a video about how water pollution occurs, how water becomes polluted, and what can we do to stop water pollution, and what are effects of water pollution on living beings. Okay, let's start our video. This video, and we will do our exercise now. The name of the poem is The Bird on the Shore. I hope you all have written it clearly. The topic is hard words. What is the topic? Hard words. So, let's start revision of fair book notes. Okay? Number one is affected. Number one is affected. Number two, floating. Number two, floating. Number three, girl. Number three, girl. Number four, pet. Number four, pet. Number five, scrubbed. Number five, scrubbed. Number six, several. Number six, several. Number seven, cleaned. Number seven, cleaned. Number eight, expert. Number eight, expert. Number nine, sticky. Number nine, sticky. Number ten, caught. Number ten, caught. So, my dear students, total how many hard words we have revised? 10. How many hard words? 10. So, you have to write 10 hard words in your fair book. If you have forgot anything to write, then this is the golden chance to complete your incomplete work. After completing the hard words, what is our next topic? Meanings. What is our next topic? Meanings. Number one, affected. Number one, affected. So what is the answer? Hostile. What is the answer? Hostile. Number two, rescued. Number two, rescued. So what is the answer? Help or to save. Help or to save. Number three, wrapped. Number three, wrapped. What is the answer? Cover. Wrapped means cover. Okay. So, how many meanings are there? Total three meanings. Total three meanings. So, I hope my dear students, you have completed the meanings with a fine handwriting. So, let's see what is next after the meanings. After meanings, what you have to write? Give one word. What you have to write? Give one word. So, now let's see how many give one words are there. Number one is a seabird with a loud call. What is the question? A seabird with a loud call. Girl. What is the answer? Girl. Number two is the girl
struck the father's hand with its beak. The girl struck the father's hand with its beak. What is the answer? Pecked. What is the answer? Pecked. Okay. So how many given words are there? Total 2 given words. So I hope you all have written it with a fine handwriting. Okay. Our next topic is answer in short. Our next topic is answer in short. So let's revise answer in short. Question 1. In what condition did the speaker and his father find the girl? What is the first question? What is the first question? The question 1 is, in what condition did the speaker and his father find the girl? Answer 1 is, the speaker and his father found the girl half dead among the sand. What is the first answer? The answer is, the speaker and his father found the girl half dead among the sand. Question number 2. What did the experts do with the girl? What did the experts do with the girl? Answer number 2 is, the experts scrubbed and cleaned the girl, removing all the oil that had made it black. Question number 2. What did the experts do with the girl? Answer number 2 is, the experts scrubbed and cleaned the girl, removing all the oil that had made it black. Let's see again answer in short. Question 1. In what condition did the speaker and his father find the girl? Answer 1. The speaker and his father found the girl half dead among the sand. Answer 1. The speaker and his father found the girl half dead among the sand. Question 2. What did the experts do with the girl? What did the experts do with the girl? Answer. The experts scrubbed and cleaned the girl, removing all the oil that had made it black. The experts scrubbed and cleaned the girl, removing all the oil that had made it black. Now, let's see what is the next topic. Answer in brief. What is the next topic? Answer in brief. So now, let's start. Question 1. How does the poem end? What message does it convey? Means, what is the ending of the poem? And what did you learn from this poem? What is the moral of the poem that you have to write in this answer? Let's see. Answer 1. The poem ends with the warning that the sticky skin of oil is still floating on the sea. The poem ends with the warning that the sticky skin of oil is still floating on the sea. The message
that conveys is that we should not pollute the sea and we should help injured birds and animals. The message that conveys is that we should not pollute the sea and we should help injured birds and animals. Right, let's read the whole answer. Question 1. How does the poem end? What message does it convey? Answer 1. The poem ends with the warning that the sticky skin of oil is still floating on the sea. The message that conveys is that we should not pollute the sea and we should help injured birds and animals. So, this was our fare book notes. So, I hope you all have written it with a good, neat and clean handwriting. If you have done any mistakes, then you have made correct it. Right? So, now let us see some information about the poet who has written this poem. This is the picture of a poet, Brian Moses. What is the name? Brian Moses. Right. Now, let us see some information about him. About the poet. This paragraph is given in your textbook only. So, let's start. Brian Moses, born in 1950. Brian Moses, born in 1950, is one of Britain's most popular children's poets. Brian Moses is one of Britain's most popular children's poets. He writes on a variety of topics such as monsters, aliens, and angels. His well-known poems include Walking with My Iguana and Sasnack Hotel. Isn't it a funny name? Sasnack Hotel. Right? You can enjoy this name. So, I hope my dear students, you enjoyed our today's session. If you are having any query, any doubt, you can message me on my WhatsApp number. Okay, so let me show you this poem again. So if you are having any doubt, you can solve it. And if you can't solve, then you can message me. On the first page, two stanzas are given with the meanings. How many stanzas are given? Two. One and two. Okay, let's move to the next page. On the next page, total three stanzas are given with a picture description about the poem. Right? So, now this was your textbook pages. If you are having any doubt regarding this poem, you can message me on my WhatsApp number. Okay? Till then, my dear students, take care of yourself and bye-bye.